Hi guys, welcome back to Ollie Talks Airsoft. Thanks for taking the time to join me today. In a moment we're going to be talking about the Tokyo Marui Gas Blowback USP full size, and I'll be doing my full review of this. But if you haven't already, please subscribe, and then you'll be notified of all my upcoming videos, because there's going to be quite a few. So let's get into it. As you can see by the box, this is a Tokyo Marui USP Gas Blowback full size. They do a compact version, which I believe came out just before this. But this is the full size. So this was a bit different to some of the other pistols that I picked up. So I actually ended up picking this up on a trip over to Hong Kong in November 2019. So I've had this, what, year and a few months. So quite a while now that I've had this. So I've had quite a lot of use. I've put it back in the box so you guys can see what you actually get. And this is how the gun will come presented to you. Pretty nice. Tokyo Marui always do a nice job with presenting their stuff. So in here, there's actually, this is where you would have your BBs, your dry fire adapters, and your barrel plug if it wasn't already installed. And as with all of the new Tokyo Marui pistols, actually behind this bit of protection, it's actually where you find the manual. I've obviously taken out of this one. I don't know where I put it, so it doesn't really matter. So let's get into the gun. First thing you notice when you pick it up is it is an entirely plastic gun, as with all Tokyo Marui pistols. So a lot of the actual weight is held in the full metal magazine. So going from front to back, you can see there's some quite nice HK trademarks on here, HK USP 9x19, and then it's got the HK markings and a serial number. It's also got a little marking down here, and it also has underneath here the read owner's manual and a serial number at the front. I'm pretty sure that that's going to be a standard serial number across all of them. And we've got the HK USP logo. So as far as this side of the gun goes, you've got all your correct trades. So if you wanted to put it on the wall, present that side. On this side, we do have the Tokyo Marui Made in Japan ASGK markings on it. And we also have some markings on the plastic barrel here, the HK markings, and also obviously the caliber. So this extractor here looks slightly different, and it is because it is actually made of metal. And there are a few metal parts on this gun, despite the fact that the main components, being the slide and the frame here, are absolutely made of plastic. But it is actually a very good quality plastic. It's not something that's going to easily break on you. So when we're looking at the metal parts on this gun, it has a metal front sight, or it certainly appears to be. Yep, it's a metal front sight, metal rear sight. This is your safety, which completely disengages the trigger. You've got your metal slide stop. You have a metal trigger here. And this is a good one for the lefties. We have a metal ambidextrous mag release here. However, the actual slide release is only for right-hand users, so it's not fully. So talking about some of the features, as you can see, the hammer's back at the moment. This is actually a decocker, so it actually decocks the gun. And when you let go of it like this, you'll notice it's gone all the way up into the safe position. So it's quite a cool feature. You can either drop it and let it go forward, in which case get the double action, or if you wanted to get it completely safe, you pull it down and let go, and it flicks all the way up and disengages. I don't know why you'd ever want to do that in airsoft. I don't think you ever want to pull your gun out and have it not work. So let's just have a quick, I suppose I'll show you the sight picture quickly. So it's a three dot affair. The front dot is quite a bit smaller than the rear dots, and it's really crisp. So I really, really like the sight picture that you actually get off this. It's clean, easy to identify. It's not muddled. Some of the old Glock ones where you had like almost a U shape that you had to line up could sometimes be a little bit tricky. This one actually, they always seem to line up really quite well. So, talking about some of the actual quality, you can see there are some seam lines on here. I'm not entirely sure of how representative these are of the real gun, because I do believe that the real gun has a polymer lower and obviously a metal slide, so you would expect to have some seam lines on it regardless. But actually, in typical Tokyo Marui style, they've actually done a very, very good job of this. I'll just note that these aren't actually pins going through, they're just moulded into the slide. Okay, so this being an all-plastic pistol, they do advertise that you should probably use 144A gas. I actually don't. I use green gas in this gun ever since I've got it. I've got three mags for it, and it's fantastic. This is a gun that I actually often end up lending to friends that want to come try Airsoft for the first time. They know that I'm into it. They know that I've got a bunch of guns. So this is a really good one to lend to people, partly for the reason that it's the newer. So you're talking about is they changed the cylinder design in a lot of the Tokyo Marui pistols, and they went, as advertised here, to a 15 millimeter large bore cylinder inside. In fact, most of them say large bore cylinder. What that actually means is, what they're talking about here is, you can see inside this here, they're talking about the diameter of the nozzle that's held within this rear section. So let's just show you that quickly, and in that I'll show you how to take the gun down. So what you need to do is, you see there's a notch in the slide here. This actually gets pushed back to line up here. There is a pin on the other side, which you push when that's lined up, and this will pull straight out. Put that to one side, and the slide comes off the front. So before we dig into the slide, this is how your lower frame assembly will look. So you can see there's plenty of metal parts. There's metal runners on the back here. And you see actually, it's all, and despite how many rounds have gone through this, not really any huge signs of wear. This is a little bit of dirt on there, but actually nothing too bad. And here's what we're talking about. So when you compare this to, for example, one of the Tokyo Marui Glock Gen 3s or any of the high cappers or anything, you'll notice that this actual cylinder here is slightly larger. What that gives you is a better blowback performance. So this particular gun is really, really, really snappy. So I don't know if you watched my Glock 26 review, but we weighed the slide on that to see how much material was actually moving back and forwards. So we're going to do the same again on this. So it's 185 grams, and that is obviously for the entire slide. And so it's great that this all remains as one part, and you can see actually there is a double spring system here. So I'll show you exactly what that does in a moment. You can then remove the outer barrel with the inner barrel in it. So this is all, obviously this is plastic, and you get the standard sort of copper Tokyo Marui barrel. You also have your hop-up adjustment, but you can actually, on this particular model, you can adjust it by sticking your finger inside the breech, so you actually don't have to remove the slide in order to do that. So this is the moving part, so let's see what this weighs. So that's 110 grams. So I seem to remember the Glock 26 was only about 90 grams, so it's not a huge amount heavier, but it's this larger diameter cylinder is what really gives this gun the extra bit of performance, and it makes it way more fun to shoot. So hopefully I will be able to reinstall all this without messing it up. That just slides in there like that. Again, we will Sorry, let's just take a second. So it slides on. And again, you line up to this part here. Get your pin in. There you go. And it, we're back to being held. So I said that I would say a little bit more about that double spring system inside. So if I pull the slide all the way to the back, that's where it stops. It's actually got a little bit extra. That's the extra comp that that extra spring is giving you. So that's one of the reasons that they put that in. So when the slide goes back, that's the stopping point. It's also got a little, when you push back a bit harder, it's just got a little bit more resistance on the back of it as well. So that's a really nice feature that they put in. And yeah, I dig it. It's good. So guns on the stall back, let's talk about the trigger pull. That's something, again, where I think Teike and Marui have done really well on this gun. I'm not a fan of any trigger where you don't have a very definitive wall. I like to be able to pull the trigger to the wall and it snaps. You can see there is a little bit of travel on this one. Nice, really loud reset. You see that extra little bit of creep there, and then clean break. So that's been cleaning up, to be honest, the longer that I've had the pistol. So it has improved. And this is a gun that you can shoot really well, and you can shoot really, really fast. So the last thing I was going to show you is in here. Hopefully you'll be able to just about see. There is actually the hop-up adjustment. So you can dig your finger in there. Hopefully you've got nails. And you can make it work. So the other accessory that comes with this, that you've probably seen in the box here, is you get a rail. So this essentially attaches onto the bottom here, and tell you what, so there we go, with the rail attached on the front. It's got two bolts, not I say bolts, they're just screws that go through. Again, it is made of plastic, but it does allow you to attach a light or something onto the front of your gun, which sounds great. So we're going to attach this on. Again, a little bit of movement because we're attaching a Surefire A onto a rail, so it's never going to be perfect. What you will notice though is when you actually hold the gun, when you would normally be actuating, your thumb is normally somewhere around here. You actually have to move it all the way down, so it's actually, it's a lot lower than you would normally have it, so it's not as intuitive and as easy to use with a torch on as something like a Glock or a high capper or something like that. So that may be something to bear in mind if you're always going to use this maybe as a main sidearm, as a main weapon like I often do, or just consider that. It's in order to find a holster for it, you might have to get something quite specific. At the moment, there aren't a huge amount of upgrades available for this either, so you are just going to have to find either a basic USP holster, or they do ones which, because this was actually a standard accessory that came with the real USP. You had this attachment rail that you could put onto the bottom. So, and I do believe that some torches actually came out that were designed for this system, but this is a system from like 70s or 80s or something like that. So they kind of moved away from it quite quickly and came out with these adapters. Either way though, this is a great gun. So let's get a little bit more. We talked about quite a lot about the externals. I'll just show you, there is no BBs in here. There's some gas in the mag. As always, it is a Teike & Marui pistol, but I'm using green gas in the mag. So I've checked the barrel, it's all clear. I don't know if you can tell, but compared to almost any other Teike & Marui pistol, this is unbelievably snappy. And it, like, the way that the trigger's set up is really nice. It's a little bit like a Glock, but I feel I can shoot this almost the same speed as I can shoot a Glock that's been broken in with like 20 or 30,000 BBs going through it, like constant, you know, two games a week for a year kind of thing. This just has a really good trigger, like straight out the box. I remember as soon as I got it, testing it out and being like, this is really nice. I wasn't expecting it. Yeah, I was expecting it to be pretty shit actually. But no, it's this large bore cylinder, and they've got it in a few of them. They've got it in the M&P series. You know what? I can't actually think of it. What else they put it in? They put it in the new Glock series, and kind of anything that's come out in the last couple of years. Look out for this 15mm big boa or large bore cylinder, because it changes the gun completely. I mean, not having a metal slide means that the slide moves so much faster, and the snappiness almost translates into what feels like recoil, because it's just getting those shots off so fast. I absolutely love it. I think even when they come out with a metal slide for this, I might be hesitant on picking one up, just because I'm actually so blown away with the way that it performs at the moment. So when we're talking about the performance of the gun, you're going to get pretty much the same as you get out of every other Tokyo Marui pistol. So you will be able to shoot people at 30, 40 metres with the pistol. It has an excellent hop-up system, and you can normally lift sort of like 2.8s and 3s out of the box. I have done with this. I can't speak for everyone, but I've dumped 3s into this and shot them as far as people are shooting their full rifles. So they are excellent, and despite obviously just being a pistol length barrel, the accuracy on these is actually pretty good as well. So what I'm going to do is I will top up the mag with green gas. I'll put some 0.2 gram BBs in, and we'll come back and we'll just run it through the chrono quickly. Okay, so let's chrono the thing. So 0.2 gram BBs in here, and green gas. It does also, I've put a purple rubber in here, obviously. Doesn't affect them actually too much. You tend to only get like 5 or 10 FPS difference. So 288. I'll tell you what. There we go. And let's just go back and review. So I only picked up 3. Never mind. They all felt the same. But you see, it's shooting standard. Standard Tokyo Marui FPS, you wouldn't expect anything different. Okay, so let's try and wrap this up. I absolutely love this gun. Who would I recommend it for? Anyone looking for a pistol. Genuinely, if you're looking for a pistol, I think this will probably fit the bill for what you're looking for. It's more fun to shoot than the Gen 3 Glocks that Tokyo Marui do. It's in fact, you know what? Out of most of my guns, this is one of the most fun guns to shoot. So it beats an upgraded high capper, in my opinion. It beats a lot of other things out there on the market. As far as upgradability goes, I kind of touched on it earlier. There isn't really much at the moment. I believe a company has just come out with a metal outer barrel. So that might be something that I might pick up in the future. But with regard to if a metal slide comes out, I'll probably give that one a miss, because at the moment, the performance on this is just kind of, it's really ticking the boxes for me. So that's all going to get left as it is. How much is this going to set you back? Well, I paid about £100 for this new in Hong Kong. Over here, I think because it's one of the newer pistols, it's probably going to run you about £130 to £140. Have a look on Fire Support. They normally have some pretty good deals. And to be honest, if you saw one of these secondhand, then not a bad thing to pick up. I would bear in mind, though, if you ever see a USP compact, apparently the mags are not interchangeable. So you couldn't use one of these mags in a USP compact, and obviously vice versa, because it wouldn't go in. So to wrap this up, we're going to go through a bit of pros and a bit of cons. Pros is Tokyo Marui. The performance is legendary on these on Tokyo Marui pistols. They can outshoot rifles out on the field. So as long as you're using a decent weight of BB and you've got your hop up adjusted, there's no reason that you can't take this out into the woods and have some really good fun with it as well. The magazine capacity, I believe, is 26 in each mag, which is about standard for a pistol. That's kind of what you're going to expect. So that's pretty good. And to be honest, the only con is it's made of plastic. If that is a con for you, I think some people, I kind of count it as a pro. This is like it's a 12 month a year, 4-season gun. I've taken this out. I went to the Bristol Crown Courthouse several times in the winter last year, took this along, and it worked flawlessly. And even with a full mag, it was always locking back on the last round, which is one of the reasons that I use this so often as a loaner gun for other people, because I can just say to them, well, when the slide locks back, drop the mag, put a new one in. And it just does it every single time. And the same can't be said for almost every other pistol. So that, for me, huge, huge pro. I kind of muddled up my pros and my cons here. But ultimately, the only con is it's plastic and it shoots 280, 290 FPS. It shoots at Tokyo Marui FPS. If you're looking at the gun, then I think what sets this apart is the hand feel, like how it actually feels to shoot. This feels better than any other pistol. And I'll do a review on some of the other newer pistols. I've got an M&PL, which I'll do shortly, but this just feels better. The plastic that they use on the slide, it's nice and thick, it's quite chunky. Everything about this is good, it's positive, it's a great gun. I kind of can't recommend it enough. I just wish I had a more viable holster system for it. But like I said, I often take these things out as primaries, so I'm happy to like take this out into the field with three mags and try to like go to town. Doesn't always work. So the final thing that I'm going to leave you with is, if you're looking at a USP, you're probably also going to be looking at the KWA. They have the metal slide. I saw Negative Airsoft did a review a while ago where he got like 150 odd shots out of a magazine. I'm not so bothered about that. As long as it can get through the 26 shots that are in the mag and lock back on the last round, that's my main concern. This is also going to be, I would say, snappier. I've shot the KWAs, the Mark 23s, the USPs. They're great. They're really good fun. They've got good recoil, but they're not as snappy. And that's where this kind of, the 15mm bore cylinder, that just, it makes all the difference. And it's kind of, it's worth looking out and trying to pick up one of those guns, in my opinion. Anyway, I'm going to leave the video there because it's already kind of long enough. Hopefully you found this useful. If you have, like, comment. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and you'll get informed about my next videos. But until then, take care.